إحسانك ولطفك وكرمك يا أكرم الأكرمين. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى كما ورد في سورة الجمعة: يا أيها الذين آمنوا إذا نودي للصلاة من يوم الجمعة فاسعوا إلى ذكر الله وذروا البيع ذلكم خير لكم إن كنتم تعلمون. صدق الله مولانا العظيم وصدق رسوله النبي الأمين الكريم ونحن على ذلك لمن الشاهدين والشاكرين والحمد لله رب العالمين. نصلي ونسلم على سيدنا وحبيبنا وطبيبنا وقائدنا وقدوتنا ومولانا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وآله وسلم. مولاي صل وسلم دائما أبدا على حبيبك خير الخلق كلهم، هو الحبيب الذي ترجى شفاعته لكل حول من الأحوال مقتهم. وانسب إلى ذاته ما شئت من شرف، وانسب إلى قدره ما شئت من عظم، فإن فضل رسول الله ليس له حد، فيعرب عنه ناطق بفمي. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. ثم أما بعد، respected brothers and sisters in Islam, first of all we thank to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this blessed day, time, and for this opportunity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala granted us. Tawfiq, we enter in His house. O Allah, we repent to You. أستغفر الله العظيم الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم وأتوب إليه. Respected brothers, today inshallah I'm going to explain a tafsir of a verse, or maybe if we have time few verses from Suratul Jummah. It's related especially with this day that we are in for Salatul Jumu'ah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in verse number 9 in Suratul Jumu'ah says, Ya ayyuhal lazeena amanu idha nudiya. O believers, there are many kinds of Ya ayyuhal lazeena, Ya ayyuhal nas, Ya ayyuhal lazeena amanu. When you accepted Islam, now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is addressing you, O believers, O Muslims. Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, O you who believe. Idha nudiya, when the call is made. Nudiya is from nida. Nida means call. Idha nudiya. From this, the fuqaha, they took that the azan. Nudiya means the azan of Salatul Jumu'ah. The first azan of Salatul Jumu'ah in these days, but at the time of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the azan was one when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was entering in Masjid al-Nabawi al-Sharif and sitting on his minbar. Then the muazzin was calling azan idha nudiya. Idha nudiya, when the muazzin give azan, when the call is made for azan, idha nudiya. So at the time of Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the azan was one, and at the time of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, when the khilafah and the caliph of Sayyidina Uthman Ghani radiyallahu ta'ala anhu came, so the Islam spread it a lot. And in the atraf, in the sides of Madinatul Munawwara, many peoples were living there, so they weren't listening the azan. When the muazzin was giving azan, they weren't listening the azan. So Sayyidina Usman Ghani radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he took this initiative and he said that we have to give one more azan. We have to add one azan before the azan of khutbah. So that one azan has to, there was a place, it's called Zawra, and that place was the place of Sayyidina Usman Ghani radiallahu ta'ala anhu. So on the top of Zawra, say you have to give azan, the first azan you have to give there. And then when you give azan, people start preparing. It's going to come in tafsir inshallah. So this was the first adding of azan. Then when the imam comes on minbar, then the second azan is going to be given. So in the time of, from this word is a nudiya, there is an azan of Jumu'ah. This is the evidence for it. Ya ayyuhal lazeena amanu idha nudiya, when the call is made. For what? لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ. And from this you can understand one thing, that at the time of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, azan was one. At the time of Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq, at the time of Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. But Sayyidina Usman Ghani radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and he felt the need, because people weren't listening the azan, so they started the addition azan, the first azan, that we give two azans. So these kind of things, these called the furu'at, the branches, that in the usul you are not changing anything, but in the furu', with the need, with the time, if you bring something which doesn't come, it's a bid'ah, but it's a bid'ah hasanah, it's a good bid'ah, that you are going to get reward because you are giving the benefit to the people, you are making it easy for them, and there is nothing that you are changing in the usuls of deen. It's another topic that I'm not going to in detail talk about it, inshallah, another day. لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ. For the Salatul Jumu'ah, when the Muazzin called for the Salatul Jumu'ah, لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ, in the day of Friday. So, and فَسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ. In Salatul Jumu'ah, the Yawmul Jumu'ah is mentioned. In the old days, before Islam, before Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, this day was called Yawmul Aruba. They were calling it Aruba. In the ancestor of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, there was one Ka'b bin Luway. Ka'b bin Luway, almost 560 years ago than Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, the Ka'b bin Luway, he was on Deen-e-Hanif, he was Muslim, he wasn't from Mushrikeen. So they were celebrating this day, Yawmul Aruba, so he changed it into Yawmul Jumu'ah. So at the, before Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, because they were gathering, the Jumu'ah is from Istima', from Jama'ah. So you have to collect, you have to be together as a Jama'ah. So he was the one, he changed the day of Jumu'ah from Aruba into Jumu'ah. In old days, the Quraysh, they were, their calendars and their dates and their months were with the name, with the death of Ka'b bin Luway. So they were using that thing. Then the Prophet sallallahu, before Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, they started using Aam al-Fil, the year of elephant. It was 55 days ago than the birth of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So then with the hijrah of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, Sayyidina Umar Farooq radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he started the hijrah calendar that we are following it until now. And Yawm al-Jumu'ah, from Jumu'ah, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam moved and migrated from Makkah to Medina. So first he stayed, he migrated on the 12th of Rabiul Awwal and the day of Monday. He migrated from Makkah to Medina and he stayed 3 days in Quba, where the Masjid of Quba is there. So he stayed there Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and on Thursday morning, at the night of Thursday, then he moved a little bit. Then on the day of Friday, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam migrated from Quba, the areas of Quba, to the city of Medina. So on his way, there was one qabila, there was one tribe, they were living Bani Salim ibn Auf, the tribe of Bani Salim ibn Auf. So they arranged the Jum'ah, the first Salatul Jum'ah they arranged for Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam while migrating from Quba to Medina city. So on their way, so this Kabila Bani Salim ibn Auf was there. So they started Salatul Jum'ah and Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam led it. إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمُعَةِ. Another thing from this we learn, the Salatul Jum'ah, that this day was very blessed day. The first thing is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam. Where many authentic ahadith are that Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created on this day. And also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam to Jannah, to enter in Jannah on this day, Salatul Yawmul Jum'ah. And also the Sayyidina Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, when he repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him out of Jannah, so he repented on this day, the Yawmul Jum'ah. So it's a very blessed day, and Sayyidul Ayyam, the Yawm of Jum'ah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave this day to Jews first, and they didn't care about it, and they made changes because of their needs. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they made their Yawm al-Jum'ah, Yawm al-Sabt. Then Yawm al-Sabt means that Saturday they started celebrating, or they started getting together as a religion, as a, you know, to worship on Saturday. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given this day of Yawm al-Jum'ah to Christians. And also then by time they didn't care about it, and they went to Sunday, Yawm al-Ahad, Sunday. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given this day to Muslims, and they care about it until now, the Sayyidul Yawm al-Jum'ah, that we are getting together. And also on this verse Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, officially ordered us, Ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu, idha nudiya lis salati min yawmil jum'ati, fas'au ila dhikrillah. Fas'au ila dhikrillah, then hasan, to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Fas'au is from sa'i. Sa'i has two meanings. One is that when you walk like a running, it's called sa'i. And one is for hasan, like you prepare yourself for something. Without looking here, there, when you prepare yourself. Fas'au ila dhikrillah. Then hasan to the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Here are the two things. One thing is nudiya lis salati min yawm al jum'ah. The salat, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned with azan. Iza nudiya, then lis salati min yawm al jum'ah. So azan is with prayer. And then fas'au ila zikrillah. Then you have to hasten or prepare yourself for what? Ila zikrillah. Zikrillah means mufassirin, they mean the zikrullah is khutbah. Khutbah of Salatul Jum'ah is Zikrullah. So it means that you have to prepare yourself earlier and come to the masjid and leave everything. Fas'au ila Zikrullah. The Mufassirin, they write here that like someone is running, so he doesn't care here, there, he don't look here, there that much. He don't pay attention because he's running. Say when you listen the first call of Azan for Salatul Jum'ah, you leave everything. You don't have to look here, there, just prepare yourself. And there are a lot of fazail and virtues that you have to do, ghusl, and when you come early, so you're going to get the reward of slaughtering a camel, then cow, then sheep, and then chicken, and then egg. So how much you come early, that much, you know, there's going to be a reward. And also in the day of Jum'ah, there is that one time, one very short time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept every kind of dua. And there's another hadith that if someone comes earlier and prepare himself for Salatul Jum'ah, so from this Salatul Jum'ah to the other Salatul Jum'ah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to remove his minor sins. So there are a lot of virtues. I am not talking about virtues, but here I am doing the tafsir of this verse. Yawm al-Jum'ah fas'au ila zikrillah. So this fas'au is ila zikrillah for khutbah, that you have to prepare yourself and come early for khutbah. And إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ يَوْمُ الْجُمْعَةِ. Azan is with prayer. And that sa'i is with what? With the zikrullah, with the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with khutbah. And in the etiquettes and adab of khutbah, when you enter, then you have to be silent. you have to be very quiet and just listen the imam and not any kind of noise or not any kind of other talking or all kind of things, because it's wajib in fiqh Hanafi, it's wajib, it's obligatory. When you come, you have to sit and listen carefully. It's wajib on every Muslim, every believer, those they come for Salatul Jummah. And also in Yawmul Jummah, here Salatul Jummah is not fard on any or everyone. Salatul Jummah is not fard on women, on children, on disabled people, on travelers, on those people they are living in village. Okay, they don't have any access. It's not fard on them. So Salatul Jummah is fard on male and people that they are living in cities. Salatul Jummah is fard on them. إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَزَرُ الْبَعِيدِ. Then the other thing, after that you heard the azan, the first azan, you start preparing yourself and take shower. And shower, it's sunnah that to do the ghusl. There is one shower and one is the major shower, like we do fi halat al-janaba. So this kind of shower you can take, and wazar al-bayt, and you have to leave aside businesses, all kind of businesses, wazar al-bayt, any kind of. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned here bayt, not ishtira, just selling, not buying. Because if someone is selling something, if he closes his shop, so no one is going to come to buy. If someone comes, the next time he's not going to come. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned just bay. So it means the ishtira and all kind of aspects, all things that we do in businesses, everything is mentioned in bay. Wazarul bay, all kind of things. It's compulsory. When you heard the azan and you are able, or if you are, it's fard on you, leave everything and come to masjid and sit and listen and offer your prayer. إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُ الْبَيْءِ. Every kind of bay, bay, ishtira, and everything you have to leave. ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is mentioning that ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. That is better for you if you know. And these, maybe in bay you can get some benefits, but the benefits of Salatul Jumu'ah, when you come on the time and listen khutbah and fulfill the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. It's better. ذَلِكُمْ خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تَعْلَمُونَ. If you know. So if you have understanding, if you know that you, it's a remembrance, it's a call from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's Yawmul Jum'ah, Sayyidul Ayyam. There are a lot of blessings in it, and we are going to get together and take the benefits. And especially, you know, something if you do just by yourself, it's different. When you do it in the group, it's very different. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, Udu'uni fastajib lakum. You have to call me, I will accept it. That you have to do supplication in jama'ah. Udu'u is a plural word. Udu'u, udu'uwa, udu'uhu. It's a plural word. That Udu'uni fastajib lakum. And collectively, that be jama'ah, then do du'a supplication, then I'm going to accept it. وَإِذَا سَعَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. Whenever, O Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whenever my servants, they ask you about me, فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ, tell them I am very near to them. حَبْلٌ مِّنْ وَرِيدٌ. I am very, very near to them. وَإِذَا سَعَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبٌ. أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِ إِذَا دَعَانِ. I accept their dua, their calls, whenever they call me. No time matter. After Salatul Jumu'ah, after Salatul Asr, or before Salatul Asr, any time that you have time, you have to do the Zikrullah. And other verses, inshallah, next week I'm going to do the other two verses of this Salatul Jumu'ah, that because there are many, many rulings in them, if I start now, that I'm not going to cover them. So, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا. O believers, remember me, ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا, abundantly. It doesn't mean that you did something that you have to forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anytime it's mentioned in hadith, in sahih hadith, you have to do the zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Zikr doesn't mean just, you know, it's with just Sufiyas or someone, just crazy people. It's not like this. Zikrullah, this prayer is zikrullah. Aqim is salata li zikri. Establish your prayer to remember me. Any kind of remembering of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is zikr. So say, abundantly to remember me. Anytime it's mentioned in hadith that you have to do the zikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that much remember, because it's the food of your ruh. your soul, this is the food of zikrullah. What is food of angels? The angels, they don't eat, but their food is tasbih and tahleel of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Their breath is, when they breathe, they remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they, this is their food. And because that our ruh is from nur, and angels are from nur, so when we do the zikrullah, remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so this is the food of our ruh, so that always our qalb, our heart is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we are thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this blessed life and this ruh and this body and this health and these all kind of bounties of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So any time that you are in prayer, outside of prayer, anywhere you are in your businesses, don't forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَسِيلًا. Day and night you have to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Alhamdulillah, Allahu Akbar, Astaghfirullah, any kind, Subhanallah, MashaAllah, InshaAllah. These are all anything that's come with Allah, 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 Allah. You have to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So one day you will see that you are not reading anything, but your qalb is that much used to, your heart is that much used to, by itself it's going to just say Allah, Allah, that you are remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala